when I was serving in Karachi as the regional security officer there for the Diplomatic Security Service, the Daniel Pearl case came about. I received a phone call at 7:10 in the morning from a woman named Azra Nomani. And Azra was working with Daniel Pearl. Daniel's wife, Marianne, was at the house where Azra and Danny worked for the Wall Street Journal. They were interested in getting an interview with Richard Reed, actually the person that Richard Reed had stayed with in Lahore, Pakistan, a gentleman by the name of Sheikh Gilani. And Sheikh Gilani was allegedly the head of a less known terrorist organization that was actually taken off the terrorist list in 2000, named Al-Fukra. So I received the phone call at 7:10, and they said that Danny had not returned the night before. The day prior, Danny had come to visit me for a security briefing. He'd advised me that he was going to be meeting with this Sheikh Gilani at the Village Restaurant, which is attached to the Metropole Hotel, a couple of blocks from the Consulate General. And he wanted to know what I knew about Al-Fukra and about Sheikh Gilani. We knew nothing about them, and that's what bothered me when I first spoke to him, because a well-known terrorist organization would be something that would be on my list and something that I would follow on a daily basis. The fact that his name had not come up and his organization had not come across my desk in any reporting led me to be concerned that he was being drawn into something that was inappropriate. So he asked if I felt that it was reasonable for him to go to the interview. And I told him that it would be, but that he needed to meet with him in a public place. And that public place was the Village Restaurant at the Metropole Hotel. Very public. He agreed that that would be the case, but he asked me, he said, he's the leader of a madrasa, and a madrasa is a religious school. And Danny said, he might want me to go visit his school. What do you think? And I told him that that was definitely a no-go. All madaris, the plural for madrasa, are essentially in dangerous locations. They typically have affiliations to the more radical elements. And for Danny to go to one of those means he's completely cut off from his communication and any safe haven or recourse. When I told Danny this, he seemed to understand it. He seemed to accept it. And as we finished our interview, the understanding we had between the two of us was that he did not intend to do that. He would hold the interview at the Village Restaurant, which was the original intent. And that was it.